Today, I'm going to talk about water. So water is so familiar to us. I have a question to you. How many different types of water do you know? Yes, three. Liquid, ice, and vapor. However, these three types of water cannot explain how water climbs up to the top of a giant tree against the gravity force. We know water is so fragile. It will be broken as soon as you pull it out. As another example, we cannot explain how this small snowflake can survive at an extremely low temperature in Arctic area. We know water gets frozen immediately below freezing temperature. More importantly, water is so close to us. As you know, water takes about 70% of our body. However, we do not know why we need that much of water for our life. That's the reason why scientists say that water is the most studied, but the least understood. Today, I'm going to introduce a new type of water. So we named chain-like water. It looks like this. It hasn't been there, but we just found it. Today, I would like to share how we discovered the chain-like water and why the findings are so cool to us. 130 years ago, the mysterious behavior of water was recognized by scientists. They proposed a very hypothetical model called the mixed model. The mixed model has been evolved with time. As you can see here, according to mixed model, water is a very, very small scale. Water is made of two components. One is clusters, the other is liquid water. However, this model has been highly debated because of lack of experimental evidence. When I joined the Boise State University in 2004, I was so interested in proving the mixed model experimentally. However, it was very, very challenging to us because its size and the mobile nature of water. Instead, we started to build a tool that can measure a delicate force generated by a water confined between a sharp probe and a flat surface. This tool also can stretch, compress those tiny water using a computerized actuator. If you zoom in those tip area by 10 million times, you will see this kind of structure. When you bring tip very close to the surface, at certain distance, the surrounding vapor condensed between the tip and surface through a process called condensation. Amazingly, my tool can actually tell us if the trapped water is liquid water or chain-like or clusters. Let's see how that is possible. This slide shows how the pulling force would be with the distance when trapped water is liquid water. When distance is small, you can expect a pretty thick bridge, and the force is large. When the distance becomes greater, Now the bridges get thinner, and the force is smaller. This graph shows just like a kind of a slash pattern. Now, so what if the trapped water is a chain-like water like this? Then when this water is in the collapsed state, just like this, it is easy to pull out. So therefore, the force is small. However, once it is stretched out, it's hard to stretch out. So this idea also can be represented by using a graph. So this graph clearly shows that it looks like kind of a tilted J pattern. This is the way how my tool can report what type of water we see. If you see slash pattern, that means that we see liquid water. If you see J pattern, that means you see chain-like water. Then the question is, what difference does the distance make for real water? We can only find the answer through experiment. Let's do experiment. Can you see J pattern and the slash pattern? In these two boxes, so you can see two J patterns. That clearly shows that the existence of chain-like water. When I saw this data for the first time, I was almost shocked. So it was one of the most exciting moments in my research career. In this slide, so you can see a bunch of chains are aligned vertically between probe and the surface. Let's go back to our original question. Does a cluster water exist at the nanoscale? The answer is yes. But it exists as a chain-like water. After further our investigation, says that the water is amazingly strong, even stronger than the concrete. Now, let's go back to our original data. So do you see liquid water? Yes. So we see two slash patterns. But in this slide, as you can see, the structure is a little different from what we learned from slash pattern. This is because the middle chain bundle is so stiff, only two bridges below tip and above sample surface is responsible against the distance variations. That's the reason why we have a slash pattern for these structures. Now, let's go back to our original question about the mixture model. Did the liquid water exist at the nanoscale? Yes. But the liquid water exists together with the chain-like water. So therefore, we proved the mixed model idea experimentally. So now, this is a water. If you zoom in this water 10 million times, you will probably see that kind of structure. But this structure is amazing because they are very complementary. Liquid water is fast. Chain-like water is slow. Liquid water likes hydrophilicity, whereas chain-like water likes hydrophobicity. And the liquid water is robust, strong. Chain-like liquid water is fragile. Chain-like water is strong. But this water is also very cooperative. After investigation, we found that these waters are really cooperative. So as you can see here, the V shape is the abrupt transition from liquid water to chain-like water. So this idea can be illustrated as follows. So if you make a very small variation in distance, suddenly those liquid water evaporated, leaving the chain-like only. So this result suggests that liquid water is both waters are very cooperative with each other. Now, How does nature adapt this amazing structure and the property of water? So now we know, right, that the water climbs up the tree in the form of chain-like water. According to physics theory, the size of a liquid should exceed a critical size to form the ice crystals. As you can see here, the chain-like water is in the way between two liquids, preventing their association, and thus preventing them forming ice crystals. Nature also uses the abrupt V-shaped transition to control the ions in a cell, such as nerve cells. So as you can see in this slide, the ions can freely move from one place to another place in the open state that we saw previously. And then now, if a molecular machine called a protein decreases the distance slightly, whatever would be, that channel is gone, so resulting in the closer state. So that's the way how the ion is controlled in our body. The answer to the question why we need so much water in our body is not easy. However, the ion channel idea gives a clue. The water is very active and also very cooperative, not just kind of a background material or just a kind of spectator. So water is a very important component in our body. So that indicated that water is very, very important in our health. I believe that the finding of this chain-like water would be huge because we can understand better about molecular function by understanding how water involved in those process. So we just discovered the water, and then now, so let's see what will happen in the future. Finally, I have a question to you. How many different types of water do you know now? Thank you.